Jeanne Schul, and I'm here at Berry College today introducing you to some asanas or exercises that are designed to strengthen as well as stretch the lower back, engage the abdominals, and focus all the time throughout the series on the breath. And Emily Barton is joining me. She's a senior dance minor here at Berry, animal science major. Hank Campbell, who is a interdisciplinary dance major, is on the camera. And we're going to start with Emily in supine. So this position means you're on your back, your feet are standing close to your pelvis, but not so close that it bothers your knees. And the first thing we're gonna do is take a deep cleansing breath. As we do, we're gonna rock the tailbone into the floor, create a tunnel under the waist. And then as we exhale, pressing all that air out, letting the spine be supported by the mat beneath us. Then again, deep breath in, releasing. This time as we exhale and press the spine into the floor, we're gonna engage the glutes and lift the tailbone just incrementally off the floor, engaging the quads, tightening the glutes, but also tightening the pelvic floor. Then we'll inhale, again, arching. This time as we exhale, fingertip touch the back of the neck, the elbows are wide. We're going to exhale, lift the face straight up to the ceiling, and we're gonna hold here, just 4, 3, 2, 1. Take a deep breath in, arch, exhale. Engage the glutes, lift the face, holding 4, 3, 2, 1. Deep breath in, let the tension go in the shoulders as well. And again, exhale, lift, holding, and squeeze. 2, 3, 4, full breath in. Releasing the tension here, last go so you get this impression. And lift and squeeze, 2, 3, 4, releasing down. Now we're gonna bring our hands on either side of the hips. We're gonna be rolling through the spine, articulating each vertebra as we go. So, to start with, we're going to do, again, that deep breath in, create the tunnel under our waist. Then, as we exhale, we're gonna engage the glutes, engage the quads, and lift the tailbone off the floor, and just hold for a moment. Then from there, we're gonna peel the weight of the pelvis off the mat and hold it. Peeling then the waist off and rolling through the thoracic spine, one vertebra at a time, rising off the mat until we have the weight across our shoulder blades. Then we're gonna bring our palms together under our pelvis, straighten the elbows if possible, and lift the shoulder blades. Here we're gonna take a full deep breath in. Imagine the abdomen rising toward the ceiling like a helium balloon. Then releasing the handhold, exhale, shoulder blades into the floor, through the rib cage, one vertebra at a time descending, finally into the waist, releasing the pelvis, and then folding those knees into our heart, stretching that low back. Then from here, we're gonna bring the feet to the floor. Now we're working to engage the obliques, the muscles that are running across the abdominals, not vertically, or crossing. And the focus here is gonna make cross-lateral contact. It can be as simple as hand to knee, can be hand to elbow, or it can be folded elbow to knee, depending on each person's ability to make that connection. We're seeing research now that's assuring us that this connection is helping with memory. Some of the research is suggesting it's what we need to do to maintain our memory. So we're gonna remember that. Your choice of connection. And we'll start by just lifting the knees and bringing back to the floor, making sure the psoas is happy with that. And then if it works, pedaling the knees off the floor. Easy breath as we go. Making that connection. And if you want it more demanding, you can keep the legs closer to the floor as you extend them. This is 5, 6, 7, and 8. From here, we're going to fold the right knee in and extend the left leg long. If you have knee issues, remember you just hold under the knee joint itself. This is a good stretch for the lumbar spine. Then, if we take opposite hand to knee, we're going to take right arm extended on the mat, looking down our right arm, take a full breath in, and as we exhale, we're bringing that knee across the midline, keeping the right shoulder on the floor in a spinal twist. This is also stretching the IT band on the outer edge of the thigh. Inhaling that knee back to center, we're going to trade hands. Now the right hand is holding the knee, and we're going to extend that thigh open, and the right elbow can be on the floor, and just circle the ankle and reverse it. And folding that knee back to the heart, lifting it as high as it's willing to go, and then sliding it out and changing. Again, a good stretch for that low back. And if you have knee issues, you can do the same work, holding over the joint. Opposite hand to knee, again, there's that cross-lateral connection. Looking down the left arm, full breath, and then exhaling as you bring it across your midline. Left shoulder staying connected to the floor. An easy breath in, back to center. Same hand as knee, going to make the connection, and then let that leg extend, opening in the hip socket and circling the ankle. And reversing, bringing it back home, lifting it, and then bringing both feet to standing. Arms open, perpendicular to the body. Now, very simply, the feet are going to stay where they are, and we're going to let the knees just drift to the right as we look left. Again, this is engaging the muscles in the low back. Inhaling center. Knees rising, exhaling, the knees will go left and our face will go right. Inhaling back to center. This time we'll inhale the hands toward the ceiling as well. And as the knees go right, the arms are going to go left. And that right arm's just going to relax across your heart. Full breath in, back to center. Exhale and change. Soften into it. The goal here is to let the weight of the bones just stretch the muscles. And inhale back to center. So another stretch here, working in the hip socket, but also in the low back and the abdominals. You're going to take your left knee and open it. Then the right foot is going to come up to the ball of the foot. The arms are wide open. And pushing off with the right foot, you're going to look down your right arm, take a deep breath in, stretch out those abs we tightened with the crunches. Exhale, low back into the floor, open that right knee, left foot pushing, looking down the left arm, deep breath in. And from here, we're going to roll onto our left side. Bring the right hand in front of your heart. Take the right leg and extend it long and roll up. And from here, we're going to bring it onto hands and knees. Sending our hips far to the right, we're going to look to the right to see if we sprouted a tail in our sleep. If it's not there, we'll shift to the left side and see if it's over there. Then with the abs lifted, we're going to wag our tail just like a puppy, back and forth. So you're rolling through the shoulder girdle, as well as the hips and the head. Very ridiculously funny looking. All right, and then from center, let's just extend the right leg. Extend the right arm, looking out, finding that balance, using the abs. If this is easy for you, then you're going to take both the arm and the leg to the side. and back to center. Deep breath in and bring them back to the mat. And we'll take it to the other side. Full extension. Exhale to the side. Full extension. And down. From here, the feet are going to go together. Knees are wide. We're going to tuck our elbows in between our knees. Use our hands as a cradle for our face. And go into Weeping Buddha. Releasing tension in the low back. Then from here, coming up, hands into the floor, we're going to tuck our toes and just stretch the knees to standing. So we're stretching the hamstrings. Engage the abs and roll up to vertical. Okay. And here we're going to find neutral posture. So working with Emily, we'll face each other, I guess, or face, yeah, let's face each other. And we're going to start with our feet no further apart than our hips are wide. So if you find the iliac crest of the pelvis, you're going to line up your knees and your first and second toe. So as your knees bend, they bend right over the toes, so they're tracking. What we want to avoid is something where the knee is falling inward or somehow tracking outside of the knee. Okay. Then from there, I'm going to take the hips toward the windows. So we're sitting into that hip. Shift it over, the opposite hip. And soft knees, and let's take a wide stance. And so just for a moment, just rock from one hip to the other. The goal is to maintain fluidity in the hips here. And then bringing it into center, so we're not one side or the other. We're just going to lift the tailbone to the back, so we're contracting in the low back. Then we're going to tuck it under. So now the pelvis is tilted way forward. And then just roll through that a couple times, contracting back and then tucking forward. Now neither of those are neutral, so we're going to come into the center of those two extremes. And then bring it up to vertical and in to parallel. Then playing with the rib cage the same way, we'll take the ribs toward the windows. Then the opposite side, just pull them back and forth until we come to center. And then pushing through the sternum, sticking the chest way out, which tends to hyperextend us, and then drawing it way back, which tends to make our vision go downward. Gives the impression of depression. Bring it center. Now see if we can find circling like a clock. 12, 3, 6, 9, 12, 3, 6, 9, 12, reversing. So we'll counterclockwise, 6, 3, 12, 9, 6, 3, 12. And then find that center location. And we're going to let the arms hang, squeeze the shoulders up. Most of us carry way too much tension in the shoulders. Release them. And again, create the tension to release it. Then the image is from the top of your head, you lift it. I'm going to come over to Emily. And with her long hair, just imagine we have a thread lifting her head to the ceiling. At the same time, the shoulder blades are released. And down. And her alignment is balanced, so there's weight on both feet, the hips are neutral, and the rib cage is centered. That's neutral posture. So we're going to begin today with a progressive relaxation. I'm Jeanne Schul, and with me is Emily Barton, and she's going to be demonstrating how well she can relax. The intention here is to go through a progressive relaxation, which actually means we create tension in the body, we feel the strength of the muscles engaged, but then we also consciously release that tension. This is very helpful for many people as a way of releasing tension so they can actually go to sleep more readily. It's also a nice way in if you're going to do some active imagination with your dreams, because it can take you into that liminal space between very awake and conscious and actually asleep and unconscious. So, with Emily, you can have your eyes wide open, you can have your eyelids heavy so you take in light, but you're not focused, or you can let your eyes close. So that's a choice each of us has as we're trying this. First thing we're going to do is take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, just feel the weight of your body on the mat, and allow that to continue to happen, becoming more and more weighted into the mat with each breath. And you're going to breathe on your own time until I invite you to deepen your breath. The first area we're going to focus on is the palms of our hands. So if you can gently turn your palms skyward. And then we're going to increase the strength that we're aware of in the palms by folding the fingers in, closing the thumb over the fingers, and squeezing the fist. And take that fist and squeeze it up toward our shoulders. And as it comes toward your shoulders, think of squeezing your shoulders off the mat. You're creating tension, then involve the back of your neck. So the back of your neck too is squeezing. You feel the power in that. Take it and squeeze just a little bit more. And then release. Let the weight of your shoulders soften into the mat. The arms extend down by your sides. Take a deep breath in. Let the neck tension dissipate into the mat. Let the weight of your arms to soften into the floor. And now with your breath, you're going to imagine that it can circulate into the muscles at the back of your neck, releasing that tension as you exhale. That breath goes down your forearms, enabling them to become more and more heavy. And the fingers release the breath as though they could just release off the fingertips. Notice the difference and enjoy it. Then we're going to take the awareness into the muscles around the eyes and the mouth and the jaw. And so for just a moment, squeeze your eyes as closed tightly as you can. Squeeze your lips tightly, engage your jaw, and feel the strength in that closing off of the light. And then inhale. And with that inhalation, imagine the tension just softening and draining, releasing around the jaw, the eyes soften, muscles around the mouth releasing. Easy breath in. And as you exhale, imagine that breath like light fingertip touch around the temples, around the eyes, and particularly releasing tension in around the jaw. And then that part of your body can just stay open and light. And now we're going to take our awareness into the core, into the center of your body. We're going to do that with the breath. So begin with a deep, full breath in. Imagine it filling through the lungs, the diaphragm rising, the abdomen rising. But as you exhale, think of squeezing all of the air out and contracting the abdomen as tightly as you can, so that your core is strong and tense. And then inhale, let that breath come in, release the tension. And then as you exhale, feel your body softening into the mat with the weight of the shoulders, the weight of the rib cage, just collapse and release toward the floor. Collapsing not so much, but releasing the tension. And finally, we have the lower body, but right now the upper body is has disengaged the tension in the muscles. So now we're going to create tension in the lower body by flexing the feet. So drawing your toes up toward your shins, the calves engage, the knees strengthen, up into the quadriceps, the thighs, and then think of squeezing the hips off the floor. So you feel all the power and the strength in your lower body. Hold it, feel that power, and then inhale, starting with the pelvis as the breath comes in. Release the hips into the floor, let the quads release, knees soften, the calves release, and yes, then the tension as though it's draining out of the toes. And now think of breathing all the way into the lungs, the diaphragm, the abdominal cavity, but as though the breath could continue through your pelvis, down your quads, through your knees, through your calves, and out your toes. For just a moment, just deepen into the breath, and this feeling of letting weight. Draw your bone structure into the mat, softening the tension. And in this place of total relaxation, I'm going to invite you to imagine your mind's eye as a screen. And on that screen, you begin to project the image of a place that would feel the most safe, the most comfortable, most lovely place. Either you have experienced or you can imagine. And in that place, begin to be aware of what colors would surround you there. Any designs or lines that come into your awareness that are soothing and comforting. And then we're also going to breathe into this space and see what we find. Are there fragrances or aromas that wave through the air? Just breathe that in, see what's there. And perhaps with that fragrance or aroma, there's a taste, this feeling of being well cared for. Staying with that can be aware of what would be the most luxurious or comforting surface upon which to lie. Perhaps it's smooth and silky. Perhaps it's furry and soft. Cool or warm. Just notice how that is for you. What feels the best. And then again, space. Notice any sounds. Perhaps there's music or voices. It could be rustling of the leaves on the trees, or the rush of water. And then knowing that you can always return to this space, gently begin to let it go. This is also a time when we can introduce an image from a dream and stay with that image. Now we're going to transition into a somatic hands-on practice, the goal of which is simply to help the person with whom we're working, again, give in to gravity, feel the weight of their bone structure, and relax even further. So as Emily is already relaxed, I'm coming to her crown, to her head. I'm very gently coming into her space. Before I make contact, just let her feel my presence. Gentle rocking. You can offer a slight range, lifting the chin just by drawing my hands closer to her spine. And very gently, the other range is drawing my hands toward me. Ever so gently. Placing your head to the mat. Then with one hand, just gently moving again the forehead. This is another way to find a neutral position for the spine. And coming into the clavicle area, thumbs on the clavicle, four fingers. She feels me coming into her spinal. Making that connection. And there's no wrong way to do this, other than being gentle in the approach. When I come to her arm, to encircle her wrist, both hands, and she's giving me her way, but not everybody chooses to or notices. You can also take it thumb to thumb, lifting, using my free hand under her elbow, release this forearm back, and at the same time using the other hand. No force, but feeling that shoulder socket with the slightest pressure, releasing tension. That's the intention. Coming back to the wrist. I'm going to take this hand cross laterally. Holding the elbow, then my hand, using the thumb again, is going to lift her shoulder and slide my hand under her scapula, then I release this hand to do what the shoulder can do what it wants. And essentially, encircling her scapula, her shoulder. Drawing out, it's like you're drawing the tension out, it comes down, you can take that arm and extend it. This is often done on a body therapy table, but you can also do it crawling around your partner. And we're going to just draw the tension out of the fingers. It's almost like you're pulling the mud off their hands. Slightest rocking motion on the bone structure can help the weight of the body release into the mat. And of course, if we do something therapeutic or relaxing on one side, we have to do it on the other. The person's going to walk around in circles all day. Just letting that shoulder feel the invitation to release. Thumb to thumb, and the leg lifted. And it's going to come up, across, just hand on the elbow, using my thumb here to help lift. I'm feeling the whole scapula in my hand now, and this hand in circles out. Now it just goes where it's going. And depending on the tension, you can hold it for a matter of minutes or longer. And then like we're brushing the tension away, we're just going to draw the hand down and invite the forearm to come to. Again, imagining just pulling that tension off. Particularly if you're dealing with somebody who is struggling with arthritis, this can actually be very helpful. But as an image of releasing tension, it works with all of us. Okay, so we worked gently with the hat through the shoulders. We're working all the way into the heart area. Now, by working just with the legs, it's going to take the energy focus through the whole lower body. So, coming to Emily's feet. It's very important whoever's doing the hands-on work actually supports and takes care of their back. So we don't want to hunch over to do lifting. We want to keep a long spine. So I'm again going to use my thumbs to rotate the legs a bit, and I'm coming under her ankles. My abs are going to need to be engaged, and then I'm going to gently lift both legs. Now this goes all the way into her pelvis, and the movement needs to be very subtle. So I want to take care of her back. Extended period of time or break. Once we invite the legs up, and you can see Emily's got a lot of natural turnout. Some people's knees are going to be pointing more toward the ceiling. Everybody's different. But hands on the shin here. And I'm doing just the slightest incremental rocking. But when we experience rocking, just like with babies, it soothes our neurological system. We don't want to shake, because that does the opposite. But just gentle rocking helps us release the tension. And that's our main goal here, is releasing tension. Now, I'm coming to one leg. And I can use my forearm on my own leg as a supportive brace. Get a little more range here, but the goal is not to stretch the person, but simply move that femur in the hip socket. So it's a ball joint, it rolls. Thank you. just like sweeping the tension off the fingers, we can do that here as well. Just feeling a release. The outer edge of the foot's an important place for us to also come into awareness. You can also create a sense of grounding for your partner by using your hand like a floor and gently pressing against. That takes the motion into the metatarsal arch there. And using your thumbs and the heel, just gentle pressure going up. From here, we'll go back to the head, to the crown. And the head tends to move with the experience, particularly in the upper body. So once again, I'm going to cradle her head with my hand. Slightly. That is a lesson. Lesson one in working with the somatic approach to hands-on.